I've been in a fight to regain my rights here, and I'm a bit disturbed by the correspondence I've been having with our public servants. They have a very cavalier attitude when it comes to violating our rights and working outside the framework of the law. If I wasn't raised in another time, I wouldn't be as shocked as it appears to be par for the course these days. It seems at every turn now, we are witnessing an usurpation of our rights from within as our public servants are grasping for power, power and authority that they legally do not have. And the result is the death of our republic by paper cut. One tiny cut at a time, we seem to lose our rights as a new restriction is imposed upon us. And it's always in the name of some fairy tale good deed and not in the name of law. I tried to warn people, but after I witnessed the restriction of respiration, I sort of knew that surfing was going to come next. It was going to become a danger to anyone or anything so deemed. So here we are, surfing, a danger to coral reef sex. There seems to be this pervasive idea that human beings do not come from Earth, that we must have landed here and thus are tantamount to an invasive species or parasite. However, everything else on this planet is good by virtue of not being human. I'm getting tired of humans restricting humans and telling humans that they're just a cancer on Earth. No philosophy of self-hatred can be a worthy one. With all that disappointment and frustration expressed, I also want to express my gratitude for you all. Your comments here have lifted me up and given me insight. They have led me to believe that we are part of something much, much bigger than we are capable of fathoming. Our thoughts, when put into the spoken word, can shape our reality. They become part of our collective consciousness. The corruption of a backwards world breeds when we are unconscious and incapable of articulating our thoughts. And it doesn't matter if that is the result of being indoctrinated or programmed, or if it is the result of fear imposed upon us. I once visited Anne Frank's house in Amsterdam, and the major takeaway I had was that we cannot be silent. And though it would be easier to just roll over and not fight for my rights or have to tell someone who is abusing their power what I think of them, it must be done anyways. It's not new to me to be the black sheep. I'll take the knocks and put up a good fight again if no one else will. Because when one man shows he has a backbone, other men rediscover theirs.